Hi everybody, I'm Claudia, international makeup artist. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to show you how to achieve this look with glossy eyes and a very bright lip. This is a look that works amazing on a special occasion, but also a look that I always do when I have editorial photo shootings because I feel like it looks amazing and it's so effortless. I cannot tell you enough how important skin is and how much you have to take care of it and make sure you have a very clean skin before applying any makeup. So this is why I will start by toning the skin with this toner just to balance it out. After that I'm gonna use the day serum, which absorbs very quick into the skin. It's perfect to use before makeup. I'm gonna also apply some eye cream in gentle motions around the eye area, and I'm also going to use a moisturizer, but a lightweight one that also has a very great SPF of 30. Following up with this Agave Lip Mask by Bite, I'm just applying it all over the lips because I want the lips to be hydrated until I'm done with the makeup. And after that I'm also going to use a primer, but this time I'm just going to use the very lightweight primer. I don't want to be aggressive on the skin at all, I just need hydration and I want glowy skin, so this is why I'm using this primer by Huda Beauty, which is a very lightweight primer, so it's very quick into the skin. After that, for foundation, I will mix two foundations today because I want a very skin-like effect, but I want a little bit of coverage because, as you can tell, my model has a little bit of redness on her face, so I want to cover that, but I still want that skin-like effect. And on the areas where I feel like I need a little bit more coverage, as well as underneath the eyes, I'm just going to use a concealer that has a full coverage. This is a Tarte-shaped concealer. After that, while we are still on cream, I'm going to use this beautiful pink blush on the tops of her cheekbones. I'm just barely touching the skin, as you can tell. I'm very gentle because when working with cream products, you have to be careful not to destroy the base that's underneath. So this is why I'm using very lightweight touches when I'm applying this blush. And I'm gonna do the same with this highlighter. This is a highlighting stick which has that glass-like effect. I love this stick highlighter. This is very great. It's by Smashbox, and I'm applying it on tops of the cheekbones and also on the bridge of the nose. This is one of my secrets in order to achieve that glass skin effect without the greasy look. So I'm setting the center of the face using this powder. I'm just using it on a smaller brush right now because I want to focus on the pore area underneath the eyes and around the nose as well. And I'm going to switch to a bigger brush and I'm going to lightly set the rest of the face as well. But I'm avoiding the areas where I apply the liquid highlighter, the cream highlighter. So this is how you keep that glass skin effect without actually looking greasy. I'm going to also use this bronzer because I love to add warmth to the skin, and to also add some contour back into the skin. I'm using it on the cheekbones, and I'm also using it on the temples, on the nose, and on the chin as well. And I'm also going to set the face using this setting spray by Benefit for a long-lasting effect. As I'm literally not gonna apply anything on the eyelids at all, I'm just gonna use some individual lashes because these make the eye pop so beautifully. So I'm applying them especially on the outer corners of the eye for that cat eye effect. After that, I'm gonna brush up the brows, making sure the brows looks flawless because the brows and the lips are gonna be the main focus on this look. So this is why I'm using the Brow Freeze by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and then I'm also making sure that I stick them a little bit onto the skin because I want that laminated effect, that very brush through effect. As the gloss I want to use on the eyes is not a very long lasting product, I'm just going to save that for later. It's going to be the last product that I'm going to actually apply on her face. So this is why right now I'm just lining the lips with this red, bright red lip liner because I want a very bright lip this time. You know I usually use browns, but this time I want a very bright red. And I'm also filling in the edges a little bit, and I'm also correcting with a tiny bit of foundation that's left on my brush. I'm making sure that the lip line is flawless. For lipstick I chose this bright pink because I really like the beautiful combination between red and bright pink, and I'm gonna just apply it on the center of the lips, and I'm gonna blend the edges very lightly because I still want that little difference between the red and the pink. I don't want it to be very blended, so this is why I'm just making sure it's a little bit blended. And after that, because I want a velvet finish, I'm gonna also apply a pink, bright pink eyeshadow on top of the lipstick. You know I love my spidery lashes, don't be afraid to apply tons and tons of mascara. I always apply several coats because I genuinely love lashes. After that, after I'm making sure that the lashes look very dramatic, I'm just gonna apply the clear lip gloss all over the eyelids, and this is what is gonna make this look very editorial and is definitely not something that you can wear all day long, because that gloss is not gonna last. It's gonna start creasing and eventually get into your eyes. So this is why I don't necessarily recommend to use it for a very full day. But if you want like amazing pictures and if you want an editorial look, I definitely recommend you try this look. And this is the final look, and in order for you to be able to slay this look, there are three things that you always must remember. Whenever you are wearing a bright lip, make sure it looks perfect. If you want the glass skin effect but you don't want the greasy effect, just leave the tops of the cheekbones wet but mattify the center of the face. And don't forget to perfect your brows all the time, because the brows are the frame of the face.